This video clip explains the enhancements made to the revision history object in ARCHICAD 19. The revision history object introduced in ARCHICAD 18 has been enhanced in ARCHICAD 19 based on customer feedback. In ARCHICAD 18, the revision history 18 object had options for two styles. Simple and detailed. In ARCHICAD 19, these options are gone, since the object has become two separate GDL objects. Revision History Simple 19 and Revision History Detailed 19. The single difference between the two versions is how they display changes and revisions. In the Revision History Simple 19 object, one revision occupies one row in the Revision History table, even if multiple changes belong to that revision. In the Revision History Detailed 19 object, however, each change of each revision is listed in a separate row. Thus, if a revision on a layout consists of three changes, the former object lists all three of them in one row. While the latter lists them each in a separate row. Most other changes to the objects are new options in the Style page of the Revision History Settings panel. In the upper right portion of the panel, in the Borders area, the Outer Border, Horizontal Separators, and Vertical Separators options are now represented by buttons instead of checkboxes. There is also a fourth button called Show Lines of Empty Rows. When this button is active, horizontal and vertical separators are drawn in every row of the revision history table. When it's inactive, they are drawn only in these rows that contain values. There are two new sorting buttons. Activating either will deactivate the other. The first, when activated, will adjust the list to the top, so rows in the revision history list will start from the top and proceed downward. The second, when activated, will adjust the list to the bottom, so rows in the revision history list will start from the bottom and proceed upward. This is a sorting option that national standards in some countries require, so now the object can meet those requirements. When using this latter sorting option, you may also want to set the first sorting option to list latest revision to oldest, and the title field's value to on bottom. This way the title is at the bottom and revisions are listed from bottom to top, going from oldest to latest. The Show Revision checkbox has been renamed to include First Revision in ARCHICAD 19. There are also two additional filtering options available in the new object. When you check the Show Latest Revision Only checkbox, only the latest revision will be shown in the list of the object. Some firms like to place a simple revision history object showing all the revisions without their details, plus a detailed revision history object showing all the details of the latest revision. With this new option, this becomes possible. Please note when this checkbox is checked, the Include First Revision checkbox is disabled since it does not apply in this case. The Filter Revisions Based on Criteria checkbox, when checked, lets you specify criteria. Only revisions meeting these criteria will be displayed in the list of the object. This can be especially helpful when the list contains a large number of revisions, or when you don't want certain revisions to appear in the list. Below the checkbox, there are three fields which work just like the fields of the Find and Select dialog. Select the criterion you wish to use in the first field, select the operator in the second, and specify a text value in the third. Additionally, you can check the Match Case checkbox to instruct ARCHICAD to check the lowercase or uppercase of characters as well during filtering. As a result, only revisions meeting the specified criterion will be displayed in the list. In this example, only items the revision ID of which does not contain 04 will be displayed as a result of the criteria. Another new feature is related to resizing. When a placed revision history object is selected, you can now see editable hotspots at the lower right corners of each cell, both in the title row and the row below it. The editable hotspots in the title row let you graphically set the width and height of the title row cells. While the editable hotspots in the next row lets you graphically set the width and height of value row cells, just like in ARCHICAD 18. One additional small enhancement related to the title row is found in the Attributes page of the Revision History Settings panel. Under the Text group, there's a new parameter called Title Text Vertical Alignment, which can be useful when a vertical height of the list text is smaller than the height of the title row of cells. With this field, you can make the title text align to top, align to center, or aligned to bottom in the title row.